That Thor run was a lot of fun, but I feel like it was missing something. Oh, that's right. I didn't hate myself enough. What could I possibly do to fix that? That'll work. Hello everyone and welcome. Today we find out if you can beat Elden Ring with only a hand ballista. We pick Vagabond for the strength and dex levels, and since this isn't a themed run, we can kinda just... Yep, uh-huh. Perfect. This is Shooty McBang, the face of destruction. I wonder if I'd have a long career as a tightrope walker. Alright, looking at the list of ballistas in the game, all two of them, there is the hand ballista and the jar cannon. To be honest, I see the jar cannon as a special weapon, so I'm gonna refrain from using it if I can. That leaves literally the only other option, big crossbow. Fortunately for us, it's accessible without killing anything. After the usual rounds of picking up golden seeds and sacred tears, we make our way to the forest lookout tower, land on the wrong square and chutes and ladders, punch this guy for using the wrong ballista, grab our beautiful massive crossbow with 5 bolts, then take the express back to Grace. Okay, so let's talk about this weapon for a second. 30 strength and 14 dex to one hand, but it can't be fired one-handed, so it's actually only 20 strength. That's not bad, but what is bad is the lack of scaling. Yep, even if I get 99 strength and pull the trigger as hard as I can, I won't be doing any more damage. That means we'll be relying almost solely on leveling the weapon to hit harder. On the upside, we can basically dump all of our souls into health, so no more getting vigor checked. I hope. The other problem is ammo. Fortunately, there are a couple vendors in-game that sell bolts, so as long as I have a stock of 99, this shouldn't be a problem. What do you mean, 5 out of 20? I can only hold 20 bolts at a time? Oh, this might be a problem. Yeah, so I didn't research this before the run, I just kind of assumed the carry capacity was 99 like pretty much everything else. Okay, maybe it's not so bad, we'll just buy some bolts. 300! 300 runes? For one shot? And 800 runes for a single explosive bolt? This is highway robbery right here. I'm gonna go ahead and make an executive decision to kill Greyall for 75,000 runes, only to buy bolts, I promise. I could have done this by picking up golden runes or farming the bowling ball, but this run is already painful enough, so please just give me this one. Let's just call our trusty steed that would never abandon me.
Oh god, he abandoned me.
We buy some ammo and levels so we can actually fire this thing. Let's go ahead and test it out on a boss. Well, that's not good. Alright, we all know the Crystallians have Giga Armor, so 13 is actually pretty solid, but more importantly, it knocked him down. That's probably gonna be useful later. After smashing the armor, we're doing 137 damage. What about explosive bolts? That should do more, right? 122 damage. This is gonna be one of those runs, isn't it? Also, if you haven't noticed, it takes us around about a decade to reload this thing. I have a feeling this is gonna go the way of dragon's incantations only, but that's a problem for future Doom. The problem for right now Doom is figuring out how to balance ammo prices and making sure this weapon does more than tickle the enemy. Guys, I'm over here. This is why you got demoted to watchguard duty. The arrow sting talisman will increase our bolt damage by 10%. It ain't much, but anything will help. Except I can't use it yet because I don't have a slot. Either way, it's time to take on our first real boss, Margit. Okay, so that interaction went exactly how I thought it would. If we fire at a distance, Margit will quite literally lean into our shots, giving us a free critical, which is great, but to be honest, my plan was to just brute force him. I mean, look at how many heals I have, and for the damage, I could probably just afford to trade blows with him. I wonder if that's gonna be necessary later. Skipping straight to Godric, because literally nothing exciting happens in Stormvale Castle, he's a cakewalk. He tries his best to dodge our arrows, but he's just so slow, I almost feel bad for him. I was told to free aim it to get the headshots and save ammo, but that's not happening. Boy, I sure hope that doesn't become necessary later. Also, I got this weird glitch in phase 2 where he does the windfire, but he didn't actually do anything, so the effect stayed on him. I've just never seen that before. Oh, you're approaching me?
I can't beat the shit out of you without getting any closer.
Looks like you got something on your nose, let me get that for you. One explosive bolt later and Godric goes down easy. It was about now that I received the single most important tip for this entire run. There's a craftable bone ballista bolt. And sure enough, the Bellum Church Merchant sells a cookbook for it. All it takes is one hefty beast bone, and wouldn't you know it, we can buy an endless amount of those if you have the Bone Peddler's Bell Bearing, which is dropped by the Bell Bearing Hunter in the War Master Shack. Okay, that's doable. Hold still, knockoff Darth Vader. Why do they always lean forward? It's over, Anakin. I have the high ground. Oh wait, crap, I missed. No way, stop my high ground! Okay, that wasn't so hard. I'm just glad it wasn't the Kaled version. Back at Round Table Hold, we claim our prize. But I actually forgot to buy the crafting kit, so one visit to Carly later and we can craft our beautiful bone ballista bolts. Get this. Each bone costs 250 runes, and they can make 5 bolts. That's an insane deal compared to the price of regular ones. Definitely negates the whole 10 less damage per shot thing. You know, I don't even know what this mist does, but I still hate it. Nice of you to drop in on me. Too bad I can't stick around. The Red Wolf of Radagon isn't a problem. He has a surprisingly low amount of health and enough time after his attacks for us to hit him. 5 bolts later and he goes down. Ow. 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 Is he gone? What in the... Where did you actually come from? So let's talk about Renala. She isn't going to be a problem, but in phase 1 you have to hit 3 of her little sweetings to break her shield. I highly doubt I can one-cycle her, meaning a lot of bolts will be wasted just breaking her shield. Because of that, I decided to use the Ballista's Ash of War, aka the Almighty Boot, to hit the sweetings. You're more than welcome to at me in the comments about how this wasn't a Ballista-only run if you want. That's fine. 8 shots later and she goes into phase 2, which honestly is the easier part of the fight. Why? Because Renala's poise sucks. 1 Ballista Bolt is enough to knock her down, meaning as long as we don't attack while she has homing magic out, we're pretty much safe. A few more shots and she goes down. And just for the record, it took 3 cycles in phase 1, meaning 9 bolts, and checking our ammo, yep, we definitely would have had enough just to shoot the sweetings. Oh well, hindsight's always 20/20. And now it's time for everyone's favorite golden horseman. You wanna see why this fight's annoying? Yep. But I have a secret weapon. Geology. See, Mr. Tree Sentinel here doesn't know how to handle rocks and will just shoot fireballs even if they can't reach me. Unfortunately, that doesn't apply to lightning, but after demonstrating our superiority in 6th grade science, he lets us pass. In the capital, we make a nice little discovery. These round trumpet boys die in 1 ballista bolt, meaning they are effectively each worth 4 bone ballista shots. Good to know in case I need to farm. You know, the capital really is one of the most beautiful and intricately designed areas in the game. I'm sure a team of dedicated people spent days, weeks, maybe even months working on it. Too bad I literally ignore all of it. At first glance, Godfrey probably sounds like a nightmare. He likes to zip and zoom around and has that huge cone AoE that'll catch us even if we keep our distance, but he has one weakness we can exploit. Godfrey is too cool to move faster than molasses, so the plan is to basically run to one end of the arena and shoot bolts at him. Just like Margit, he'll actually lean into the attack, giving us a free headshot, and if we do it at the right distance, we can actually avoid the cone stomp. Godfrey, I love you. I hate to do you dirty, but I never knew your weakness was just standing far away. Alright, let's get a little free aim practice in on this completely stationary, very easy to hit target. Nailed it. Oh, Morgott, the beginning of the end. Okay, so anyone who has ever used slow weapons probably felt the game's difficulty start to increase dramatically with Morgott, because he's the first of the game's really agile bosses. Fortunately, in phase 1, he doesn't seem to care to dodge our projectiles, instead opting to follow up with his daggers, which we have no choice but to eat, but they do minimal damage compared to literally the rest of his kit. But that's where the fun times stop. In phase 2, he will absolutely dodge our shots if we fire them willy-nilly, so that's fun. If you can bait him into a sword grab from a considerable distance, it's usually safe to hit him, depending on his follow-up. That being said, this big hammer spin move is your best bet. If you're already running away from him, he won't be able to hit you, and as long as you fire early enough in his animation, you'll have enough time to dodge the follow-up. I actually tried to get him to jump into my bolts, but I guess he also has iframes on dodges? Or I just suck, I don't know. It took a couple tries and a little bit of luck, but let it be written on his grave, felled by Shooty McBang. Melina tells us to go on a quest to the far north, and like a good little ballista-wielding psycho we go. Sir, I'm trying to get onto the elevator. Well fine, see if I hold the door for you. Mr. Crow, do you need any help? Huh, I see he's already lent you a hand. Okay, who's next on the list of things that need to die? Oh yeah, the fire giant. Huh. So I actually forgot about this boss until just after Morgott, and I have been terrified that I won't have enough bolts to bring him down. But maybe I'm worried for nothing, let's just hit him and see how much damage we do. Well, that doesn't bode well. Checking the wiki, he has approximately 43,300 health, and we have 80 total bolts. Doing some quick math, that means each bolt needs to do at least 540 damage. Which we actually do, so as long as we don't miss, this is totally doable. But that's hitting the giant's weak points. Otherwise, we do about half the damage necessary to bring him down. So not only do we have to land a fair majority of our shots, but they actually have to land in specific places. That's all fine and dandy, except for the fact that the fire giant isn't going to just stand there and let me pelt him with bolts. He's gonna fight back. And he hurts. Like a lot. Nevertheless, I persevere and take him into phase 2. where 10 seconds in, he rolls on top of us. Okay, it's fine. Let's just try again. I was burning through bolts at this point, and the pressure was rising, as if I run out, I'd literally just have to farm for more, and that sounds even less fun than doing this run. But then I made a little discovery. You can bash from horseback with a hand ballista. Now wait, I know some of you will say that this invalidates the run, but let's take a look at the ballista. Okay, so we have the sharp stick shooter end, and we have the blunt hitty end. As far as I can tell, the whole thing is the ballista. In fact, I can make a case that only this fight is truly done with the ballista itself, as all the other fights have been done with the bolts. I'm joking, but for those of you who still think this invalidates the run, by all means comment down below and tell me how wrong I am, but I just ask one thing of you. Please wait until the end of the video, because I pay for this. The hubris I had in thinking I had outsmarted the game comes back to bite me in the ass tenfold. I promise. Anyway, after what feels like several hundred whacks in one bolt, again, my hubris is showing, the fire giant bites the dust and we're off to fabulous Pharaoh Missoula, home to such wonderful things like crazed beastmen, tornadoes, dragons, the worst enemy From has ever invented, and the one, the only, Godskin Duo! Still hate this fight. It was here that I learned another little trick of the hand ballista. The bolts actually pierce enemies. That sounds like a good thing, right? And normally it might be, but in this fight, not so much. But why, I hear you cry? If you can basically double the damage for one bolt, how could that possibly be bad? Well, dear viewer, I am glad you asked. This is just my experience, but it feels like the Godskins operate on three tiers of aggression. Tier 1 and 2 everyone knows about, it's basically phase 1 and 2, but I think there's also a tier 0 when they're at full health. Maybe I'm just crazy from doing this fight too much, but it really feels like when they're at full health, they're much more passive. Or to put it another way, a single tick of damage will cause them to more aggressively walk towards the player, meaning it's harder to keep them separated. Am I the only one that feels like this? At any rate, it means that accidentally shooting both of them is a problem. What's not a problem though is the jank hitboxes of these pillars. I was attempting to hide from a fireball and retaliate, but in doing so I found that you can shoot through the pillars. And I don't just mean the corners, I mean like, the whole thing. The bolt will just fly through it. So the strat quickly became shoot through the pillars until the noble was in phase 2, then get 2 or 3 free shots on him doing the roll and hope the apostle doesn't smack me from nowhere or jump in front of my shots. After only a few painless attempts, they go down. Also, I just wanted to show off this weird glitch where the explosion hit the pillar in front of me and the apostle. Then the very next shot it hit the pillar and the wall behind him, but not him. And yes, I know it's the explosion and not just firing the bolt because when I backed up and fired, there wasn't one. Target acquired. Oh, that's satisfying. Let's try that again. Target acquired. 68? Now that damage drop off is nothing to laugh at. My first thought when fighting Malaketh was to see if the pillars here were also jank. The answer is no. We can still use them to our advantage to stop his boulder throwing, but his other beast attacks? Yeah, not so much. I was worried about phase 1, but nothing could prepare me for his phase 2. Malaketh the Black Blade is hands down, without even the faintest shadow of doubt, the easiest boss in this whole run. What? Don't believe me? Let me show you. This. This right here. Remember in the Thor video how I complained about the hitboxes? Oh, how the turntables. 100% of the time that Malaketh jumped away from me, I would fire, he would run up, and follow up with this sword swing, and our reload animation would put our character hunched over far enough to dodge without doing anything. I might have just gotten lucky with him always following up the same way, but this happened every single time. At this point, the fight is basically just play keep away until my guaranteed window, and after having done this fight so many times, I'm an expert at dodging his attacks. Usually. And this is it, my friends. This is the moment I reached peak hubris, where I thought I was king of the lands between, but in reality, the game had enough of my shit. They say pride cometh before the fall, and boy did I sure plummet. But first, some comic relief. Gideon used to be an adventurer like me, but then I blew his kneecaps out with a ballista. Holy crap, he tanked that better than I thought he would. I didn't mean it, Gideon. I'm sorry. No. Gideon here is a perfect example of why I haven't done the right card questline yet. For those of you unaware, because you aren't crazy enough to do a run like this, NPCs will dodge projectiles. Like, 100% of the time. Unless they are already locked into an animation and can't dodge. Fortunately for us, he has two such animations. The better of those two is when he casts Law of Causality, this little T-pose spell. It's slow enough that you can hit him if you see him start to move his hands. The second attack is actually the Kamehameha Wave. The problem, though, is that you basically need to fire the moment you see him move and hope he actually picked the Comet Azure spell. Because if you guessed wrong and it's the normal Comet, well, that's free damage. For him. Pro tip, you can actually use the stairs in this room to stop Comet Azure, making it way safer to retaliate, but whatever. A few minutes later, and the All-Knowing is now the All-Dead. With that over, it's finally time for what you've all been waiting for, my descent into madness. Godfrey, the first Elden Lord. Oh, how I love this fight, but I had no idea what I was in for. Phase 1, easy. It's quite literally the exact same as Golden Godfrey with the added Mega Quick Attack. I wouldn't recommend trying to hit him after that either, because you usually can't get enough distance to avoid his follow-up stomp, but it's Phase 2, after the Roar, where shit really hit the fan. Oh, you liked running away and shooting bolts at him? Well, that's too damn bad! If you are anything more than melee distance away from Godfrey, he will rush towards you with an arena-wide AoE stomp. Oh, you liked being able to shoot him without always taking damage? Ha! No, we don't do that here. I found exactly one attack that gave us a clean opening, and it was when Godfrey stomped first, then followed up with his axe swing. As long as we were far enough away to avoid the axe and make sure his next attack was a zip and stomp, we could avoid damage. But in my 4 hours of doing this boss, he did this attack exactly 3 times. Maybe 4 hours doesn't sound like a lot for a boss, but I want you to think about how often Godfrey attacks in Phase 2. Only 3 times in 4 hours? I don't like those odds. The practical strat is to instead bait a melee attack, preferably one with a long animation, then run far enough away that when he rushes towards you, the only damage to hit you is the AoE stomp, not his actual foot, as it does way less damage. Guzzle Estus, repeat until phase transition. Speaking of phase transition, if you thought Godfrey Phase 2 was bad, just wait until you get to Horaloo. We died over, and over, and over again. His grabs, which you are absolutely going to be hit by, do so much damage I might as well not even be wearing armor. And this is after taking off Radagon's Sword Seal. My first fit of desperation was leaving to murder this Erdtree avatar for the Crimson Burst here, giving us a bit of heal over time. I thought if I had to take damage, I could then run away and get some extra health back just by dodging around. Spoiler alert, it wasn't enough. I tried changing my armor for more protection, not once, but twice, and guess what? It also wasn't enough. And every time we failed, it was back to Godfrey to do it all over again. After slamming my face into this chiseled brick wall, I started losing it. I unironically think Melania would be easier. So, you know what? I'll be back for you, you roided out wrestling reject. Commander Nail is actually pretty easy. His two buffoons only take 3 bolts each, and we can lock the commander into a nice little loop that guarantees we can hit him without taking damage. Until he does something different out of the loop, and I'm not ready for it. Heh, stupid. Oh god, I'm sorry. Loretta isn't terribly difficult. Yep, easy peasy. She actually isn't that bad. As long as we avoid getting hit with too many stacked spells, she doesn't do nearly enough damage to be frightening. After just 3 tries, she goes down. Time to see if I was right about Melania. Let's just take a shot at her. Well, that's not good. Unfortunately, our bolts are slow enough for her to dodge. That's okay, I still know her openings, and the good news is that the ballista knocks her down. But sometimes she doesn't care. And sometimes she jumps straight into waterfowl anyway. I'm sensing a bit of a problem here. Oh holy crap, I lived. I guess that's what happens when you put literally every stat point into vigor. I still think this is going to be easier than Horaloo, but we aren't doing a lot of damage, so we quickly head over to the Lux Runes to grab the Ritual Sword Talisman, which will raise our attack power by 10% at full health. Phase 1 is actually pretty simple. Bait out this specific attack, run as far away as possible, then time the shot to where it hits after her hyper armor has ended, but before she can dodge, thus knocking her on the ground and giving us plenty of time to react. At this range, the only attack that'll reach us is waterfowl, and that is 100% of the reason why we put this much distance between us. I actually start free aiming at her to try and score some headshots. The damage is amazing, but if you miss, try not to miss. Just like shooting fish in a barrel. Whoa, I have never seen her cancel that attack. Oh wait, Melania, stop! Phase 2 is even easier because she has more openings. You're basically looking to bait any ground slam move and then knock her down. And if she ever does Scarlet Aeonia, that's 2 free hits. I did make a mistake in thinking that it would be exactly the same timing as using the Bolt of Gransax. That attack has a longer startup animation, meaning when I attacked at the same time with the Ballista, she still had her hyper armor and, Oops. I've been getting pretty good at these headshots. Oh. Oh, no, Melania, I'm so sorry, Oh, you're not gonna murder me? You are a kind and merciful goddess, because I should have absolutely been chopped to pieces in that interaction. Alright, one hit away. Good night, you rot goddess. Just like I predicted, she was easier than Godfrey. Oh, and here's the Rodan fight. I've been wearing his armor for a bit, but nothing interesting happened in that fight, but I just wanted to include it in case someone thought I didn't do it. Our vigor is so ridiculously high for this fight, we don't really have to worry about anything, and our ballista is like a plus 24, so we do a large amount of damage with each shot. Anyway, back to the pain. Godfrey, I told you I'd be back for you, and this time I have a slightly different plan. I'm gonna stand far away and snipe you. Normally I use the bone bolts first because they are inexpensive, but they actually drop like a sack of potatoes. Using the regular bolts and quite literally the whole arena, I could get in chip damage while staying perfectly safe. It works great! Right up until phase 2. And before I know it, I'm back in the cage match of the century. So in my time away, do you think I've developed some sort of strategy? Nope. There is actually a way to get damage on him without being hit. His roar. The problem is, you have to attack before he starts it, meaning if you decide to attack and he does literally anything else, you're gonna have a bad time. If he does the roar, you'll either be far enough away to avoid a follow-up, or close enough that you get knocked back, meaning you can act sooner to still avoid damage. In the end, this strat wasn't consistent enough. His roars might be on a timer, but after bashing my head against this wall for so long, I couldn't count past 3. I'm sorry? You wanna run that by me again? Ah yes, how could I forget Horalu's very rare psychic attack, Invisible Gut Punch. In the end, we basically just had to perfectly execute Godfrey to make sure we had enough heals to face tank Horalu, and I am so glad that's over. The game had humbled me. It couldn't possibly get any worse.
Bitch, you thought?
The game was absolutely not done humbling me. Radagon. I love this fight. Wait, that doesn't sound right. That must be a typo. I meant to say I hate this fight. So the first issue is, obviously, do I have enough bolts to get through both fights? No. Unless you score more than a few headshots on Radagon, but do you think he's just gonna stand there and take it? Well, actually, for the first shot, he does just stand there and take it, but after that he won't, and if you miss this shot, you might as well just quit out and restart. This fight is a dance, and you are absolutely not the leader. In the 5 or so hours of attempts, I made it to Elden Beast 4 times. 4! The best attack he can do is his grab. Just run away from him, and the moment he slams his hand down, free aim and pull the trigger and hope you're fast enough to move the cursor over his head. After that, you can run away from the wave and try and shoot, but make sure you're far enough away because if it clips you, well, joke's on you, you just took damage for no reason. One thing I found that sometimes worked is running around him and shooting up at him. In phase 1. Because if you try that in phase 2 or 3, he might just decide to teleport out of the way. Awesome, cool, I love it. I was losing my mind in this fight. There would be times where I would fire and he would hit me and not knock me out of the reload animation, meaning I would get hit again. That's right, I had too much poise. At some point I even went and played the worst game of Ring Around the Rosie with Sanguine Noble, that way I could pick up the Hallig Drake Talisman plus 2, though that's more for Elden Beast than it is Radagon. Am I stupid? I actually just straight up forgot he can catch projectiles. This is after having done consumables only and bow only, but in my greed I wanted to finish this phase, and I paid for it. After many, many attempts, we finally get to see Elden Beast. Thankfully, he's much easier than Radagon. In fact, he's such a big, slow, easy target that you have a guaranteed follow-up after several attacks. Phase 2 is where it gets a bit dicey though, specifically with Elden Stars. By itself, it's annoying, but when it's coupled with other attacks? Yeah, in what world is that fair? 2 homing attacks, then a smokescreen to cover his sword swings? Great, awesome, I love it. And here we see me having gone completely insane and trying to punch Radagon to death with my bare fists. Eventually, after what felt like an eternity, I went into Elden Beast with nearly full health and 3 backup flasks. As long as I didn't make any mistakes, we can do this. Sure enough, after hours of attempts, the beast is dead, and we have proven that you can beat Elden Ring Hand Ballista only. Except we aren't done. At this point, Mog kind of feels like a victory lap. He just lumbers towards us slowly, and he has a sizable forehead, so landing headshots isn't that bad. Basically, run to one end of the arena, get 1 or 2 shots, dodge, repeat, 2 attempts later, he's dead. But now we have Rykard. It's completely possible to beat phase 1 with Ballista only. The problem is doing that while taking minimal damage, and since she has this stupid attack, I don't know how you're supposed to do that. I decided to do the same thing as with Thor, where I would push phase 1 with the Serpent Hunter just to have as much healing as I can to see if it's possible. To my surprise, it might actually be. This is the closest I got, and I had 27 more shots. With a bit of better luck, I think it's doable. But honestly, I was just so far done with this run that I didn't want to shorten my life anymore. Hell, the Radagon fight probably took 10 years off of it. Rykard is a gimmick boss. I had no problem smacking him down with the Serpent Hunter spear. And with that, all shard bearers are dead, and this character is getting thrown out back until the DLC comes out. Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching. This run, honestly, I actually got to the point I just wasn't having fun anymore, and that's saying something because I beat this game consumables only. To be honest, it wasn't so bad until Godfrey and Radagon, and at that point, it was just the worst. The reload on the Ballista is so slow, it just forces you into situations where you have to take damage. For reference, this script is 13 pages long. 6 of them are me complaining about those two fights. I am absolutely terrified of the DLC. But once again, I say that as a problem for future Doom. If you've made it this far, please consider giving a like and subscribing, it really helps me out, and drop what challenges you want to see happen down in the comments below. But until next time, my friends, don't you dare go hollow.